Hello everyone, in this video we are going to solve question number 2nd. In question number 2nd you have to find the Pythagoras triplet of these numbers, or you can say one of the Pythagoras triplet is 6, you have to find the other 2. Before solving this, you have to we must know one thing is any number which is greater than 1 has a particular formula for the Pythagoras triplet, that is m square plus 1, m square minus 1 and 2m. This is the general formula for any natural number where m is greater than 1. So these three numbers must be a Pythagoras triplet. So in first question, 6 is a Pythagoras, one of the number of the Pythagoras triplet. So 6 must be one of these numbers. So putting the value of 6 as m square plus 1 equals to 6. So m square is 6 minus 1. So m square is 5. So value of m is root 5, which is not a perfect number. So this 6 is not this number, so we can again put 6 as m square minus 1. So m square minus 1 is equal to 6. So m square is 7. So m is root 7. Again, this is not a perfect number, so this must be the last number. So 6 is equal to 2m. So m must be 6 by 2. So m must be 3. And this is cancelled out, we give 3. So the value of m is 3. If the first number is 2m, the second number must be this, or n here, the value of m is 3. So the value of this must be 3 square 9 minus 1, 8. So the other number must be 8, because the value of 3, m is 3. And the last one is 3 square plus 1. So this is 8 and this is 10. So the next number must be 10. Same process we have to apply on these cases. So the value of this must be equal to 2m. So in this case, 14 is equal to 2m. So the value of m must be 7. So if the first value is 14, the second must be 49 minus 1, which is 48, and this is 49 plus 1, which is equals to 50. So the other remaining two triplet should be 48 and 50. Same case with this. Here the value of 2m must be equals to 16, so the value of m must be 8. If the value of m is 8, so one of the triplet is 16, then the other one must be 8 square, which is 64, minus 1 is 63, and this must be 65. In the last case, here the value of 2m is equals to 18, so the value of m must be 9. And if one of the number is 18, means 2 into 9, so the remainder must be 9 square 81 minus 1, which is 80 and 82. So this way we can find the Pythagorean triplets. Thank you.